Your Excellency Ambassador Volkan Bozkir, President of the General Assembly, Your Excellency Ambassador Yashar Aliyev, Permanent Representative of Azerbaijan, on whose behalf I greet all my colleagues, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. As we know, COVID-19 has caused severe impact on societies and economies across the globe. It constitutes the most challenging crisis in recent history, and we should face it without abandoning the fundamental principles of this organization, which should be based on the efforts of individual nations acting in a concerted way. COVID-19 must not be taken as a pretext to advance agendas that extrapolate from the constitutional structure of the UN system. Despite its worldwide reach, the pandemic affects individual nations and peoples unevenly. The United Nations should serve as a platform for member states to share their experiences and practices during and in the aftermath of this crisis. Brazil reaffirms the primary responsibility of governments to adopt and implement responses to the COVID-19 that are specific to national contexts. There is no possible one-size-fits-all solution. While we recognize the mandated role of the WHO in the pandemic, we have also identified critical shortcomings in that organization that must be addressed as soon as possible. COVID must lead to better multilateral institutions. They must be transparent and accountable. We should not transfer any responsibilities from the national to the international level just to follow the nice-sounding clichés like the world needs more multilateralism or global problems require global solutions. Clichés will not help us face the pandemic. Only national work and cooperation among nations with the international organizations serving their indispensable role as the locus of a coordination and provider of cooperation will do that job. The fight against the virus is no less critical than initiatives to mitigate its social and economic effects. We are all confronted with the difficult task of protecting the lives and guaranteeing the livelihoods of our populations. Hence, it is my hope that today's debate makes a meaningful contribution in this regard. Brazil has adopted bold actions to address the challenges raised by the pandemic and to tackle the resulting economic crisis. We are providing emergency assistance to approximately 67 million Brazilians, which allows them to cope with the pandemic and maintain their income, especially those in the informal sector and the unemployed. Our expenses to guarantee the subsistence of the most vulnerable in our population amount to more than 8% of GDP. This burden falls onto Brazilian taxpayers, not on any multilateral institution. The Brazilian economy remains resilient. Economic growth has resumed, agricultural production has achieved record levels, and unemployment remains under control. During the pandemic, we kept our agricultural production, which was responsible for feeding 1.2 billion people. Again, this was a national effort, not the result of any multilateral institutions' efforts. I don't say this to blame anything or on multilateral institutions, just to emphasize that national efforts and national responses, in our case, were fundamental to face the COVID crisis. Brazil has also been making continuous efforts to provide every citizen with the necessary care and treatment. The public health system ensures access to universal and free health care for all 210 million Brazilians. We believe that strengthening access to medicines, vaccines, diagnostics, and other health products is key for defeating the virus and saving lives. We recognize, of course, the importance of international cooperation. Brazil participates in several international initiatives to promote the development of health technologies to combat COVID-19, such as the ACT Accelerator, the COVAX facility, and the Solidarity Call to Action. Brazil also signed a memorandum of understanding with the University of Oxford AstraZeneca for the acquisition and production of vaccines, including the transfer of technology. We are investing in 6 domestic vaccine projects developed by universities, public laboratories, and state technology companies. The Ministry of Health estimates that BioManguinhos Fiocruz and the Instituto Butantan, 2 of the biggest public research institutions in Brazil, together with domestic pharmaceutical companies that have specific arrangements with foreign laboratories, will be able to produce 600 million to 800 million doses by mid-2021. With this level of production, Brazil hopes to be able to actively contribute to immunization efforts in the region and across the world. Brazil has been working closely with neighboring countries, especially with our Prosul partners, but also with countries from different regions to share best practices and lessons learned about the pandemic. Brazil cooperated with PAHO in training technicians from countries of our region in detection techniques for the new coronavirus at an earlier stage of the global pandemic. Brazil is deeply concerned by the negative impacts of the pandemic on the physical and mental health of all individuals, including health workers, persons with disabilities, older persons, women, children, and youth. Special measures were adopted to protect vulnerable groups, especially our indigenous population. We have adopted and implemented in a timely fashion a national strategy aiming at strengthening services on the prevention and control of COVID-19 among the indigenous population, respecting their cultural and geographical specificities. In the context of the pandemic, we invested in family-oriented policies, which take into account the different needs and expectations of families to promote healthy relations within the family. Brazil is a proud member of the Partnership for Families, together with the United States, Poland, and Hungary, and we will keep championing this agenda abroad, including as a tool in the fight against COVID-19. As the United Nations celebrates its 75th anniversary amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, it is an opportunity for all nations to renew our commitments to the values enshrined in the UN Charter. As President Bolsonaro underscored in his statement at the opening of the general debate last September, Brazil is a founding member of the UN and hence is committed to its basic principles: peace and security, cooperation among nations, respect for human rights, and fundamental freedoms. Fundamental freedoms are not an ideology. Human dignity requires freedom as much as it requires health and economic opportunities. Those who dislike freedom always try to benefit from moments of crisis to preach the curtailing of freedom. Let's not fall for that trap. Totalitarian social control is not the remedy for any crisis. Let's not make democracy and freedom one more victim of COVID-19. Thank you very much.